Well, hello everyone. Welcome back to a new tutorial on creating a navbar for your website. We'll walk through everything step by step from top to bottom, so hold on tight because this is going to be crazy. All right, let's kick things off with a fresh blank editor. Now, if you look over to the far left, yep, right there, you'll see the insert panel. That's your toolbox. It's packed with all kinds of design and development modules. Now, what we're gonna do is build the basic skeleton of our navbar. Super simple stuff. So if you head over to the pre-built sections area, you'll notice there are a bunch of ready-made navbars, each with its own unique style. Let's take a closer look at the first one and inspect how it's built. And if we break down the structure, here's what we find. There's a section, inside that a container, and then a nav wrapper that holds all the nav elements. Clean and classic, right? We're gonna treat this as our go-to standard structure, and from there, we'll build our own custom version. Now, yes, we could just start designing right from the ground up using the navigation element. Since we've got a lot to cover in this video, we're gonna save some time here and roll with the pre-built structure. But if you wanna see a full navbar built totally from scratch, drop a comment below and let us know. We've got you covered. All right, first things first, we're giving our page a bright yellow background. And just so you know, when you're styling the entire page like this, the changes will stay constant all over the page. The next thing we'll do is change the navbar color. Since we're designing a navbar with a pitch black background, we'll just go ahead and set that up. Oops. Now the nav contents are barely visible. If we change the link text color to white, it'll be much easier to read. So let's fast forward and do just that. First, let's expand the navigation from the Layers panel. You'll see that each item is wrapped in its own div, kind of like its own little container. Now, when we select the link text, check out the class manager on the right. You'll notice a class is already assigned to it. So, what exactly is a class? Think of it like a labeled box that holds all the styling rules for that element. In our case, this selected class is what's controlling the look of our link texts. If you click on the other links, you'll see they all share the same class. But there's something a little different about the Home link. It has one extra class added by Droip. That's a default class for active states. For now, let's make the Home have a neutral state to style things consistently. Let's quickly rename the class to something cleaner. How about link texts? Much easier to track now. So, here's the cool part. Since all the links share the same class, we only need to style one, and the changes will apply to all of them. Let's check that in action. Now, set the font color to white and boom, it's readable again. Still looks a little dim though, so let's bump the opacity to 100%. And there we go, nice and clean. All right, so we'll probably need four links in total. Home, About, Services, and Projects. Home and About are already there, so let's go ahead and rename the other two. We'll update them one by one, and don't forget to rename them in the Layers panel too, just to keep everything nice and tidy. Now, let's get rid of that extra link and the button. We won't be needing those for this layout. And, yep, that's looking way cleaner already. Let's just zoom out the viewport a little for a better look. Perfect. Looks like the logo needs a quick fix. No biggie, we'll just replace the existing SVG code with our own, and done. Now, to tidy things up, let's give the whole navbar a little breathing room by pushing the content slightly downward. We'll do that by adding some top padding to the section element. Yep, right there, looks good. Next, we need a bit more spacing on the left and right sides of the nav wrapper. To do that, let's lock the structure dial, then deselect the top and bottom padding. Take a quick tip. The cyan border shows padding, and the reddish border is for margins. Handy to remember while adjusting spacing. Let's set the left and right padding to 20 pixels. Nice and balanced. And just like that, the nav bar is ready to roll. Let's give our nav bar a little flare with some rounded edges. Head over to the border section and adjust the radius. A subtle 4-pixel curve does the trick. Nice and sleek, and that's almost everything. Wait, hold up. We totally forgot to change the font for our link texts. So let's fix that. From the navigation, select any of the link texts. Then go to typography and search for the font called Jersey 10. Looks like it's not installed yet. No worries, we'll just look at the bottom, hit Add Font, and search for the font in the panel. There it is. Select it, click Add in the bottom right corner, and boom. It's now added to our installed fonts list. Close the panel and you'll find Jersey 10 in your font stack. Let's also bump the font size up to 18 pixels for better readability. Now, let's make these links actually work. Click on any link text and you'll see a link option appear. From there, you can select different types of pages. We've got our basic pages already published, so all we need to do is connect each one. Similarly, we will update the links for about, services, and projects. So, if you are thinking where these pages came from, for your clarity, we already have our pages ready. And it's that easy to link with a few clicks. Alright, so when we preview the home page, our navbar is good to go. Now, when we select to these links, we will be navigated to the corresponding pages. So, after we click the services page, it takes us to the services page. But wait, how do we get back to the home page now? Well, that's exactly what we'll be tackling. Let's hop back into our editor. We'll select the entire header, everything including the design, elements, and structure. Now, right-click, and down at the bottom, you'll find the Create Symbol option. Let's name it Navigation, and assign it to a group, let's say, Header, to keep things nice and organized. Did you catch that? The header just changed its appearance, because it's now a symbol. Next, head over to the Symbols tab under the Insert panel. You'll see our newly created header group listed there. Click the three dots of navigation, select Set As, and choose Header. And you can also unset that anytime. By setting a symbol as a header or footer, you're basically making it global, so it shows up across all your pages automatically. You might have noticed that there are now two navbars showing. Simply, we'll just delete the old one that's still listed as a symbol in the Layers panel. That's it. And here's the best part. If you ever want to tweak your navbar, just double-click the symbol, make your changes, and they'll update globally across all pages. So clean and efficient. We will cover that some other day, but for now, let's quickly check if the services page is showing the navbar. Now, when we preview the home page and jump over to services, our navbar is right there. No extra work needed. That's how you set a global header, or footer, to keep your site consistent and save a ton of time. Let's quickly recap what we've learned. We covered how to change background colors, how to manage and reuse classes for smoother workflows, how to use the structure dial to adjust margins and padding, how to add borders, and even how to install custom fonts and add them to your font stack. We linked our nav items to the right pages. Oh, and of course, we wrapped it all up by setting the navbar as the global header through symbols. Simple, clean, and totally beginner-friendly. In the next video, we've got another exciting tutorial coming your way, and we'll see you soon.